Today's event is mostly about empowering everyone to get out on November 4th to vote. Not only that, if you are able to vote early, we ask everyone to get out and vote early because we want to keep the lines down at the polls. Not only that, we want to make sure everyone has been registered to vote. We went from Orangeburg, South Carolina to Rock Hill, from Rock Hill to Columbia, from Columbia we're now here. I challenge every young person, if you have a voice, make it known and clear. Get out and vote. If you have registered, get out and vote. When you get in the line, don't feel as if, okay, my vote won't count. Your vote do count. Yes, it does. We ask everyone to think hard and vote hard.
Vote hard!
I'm the president for the SEC State Chapter.
If whoever wasn't here, like, they probably would miss out on a good experience, but, like, it was, I'm not gonna lie, it was kind of tough at, like, the last stop we stopped at. Because, like, some people, you know, everybody don't want to hear what you got to say, but you just can't get discouraged from what they're saying. You got to just keep going and keep encouraging others. People who try to do this before us, like, they would feel good to see young black people in the community trying to get people to vote and do things that they fought for us to do for a long time. And they should be glad that we're taking advantage of the rights that we have to get things done. I'm part of the Orangeburg Youth Council. I'm the second vice president.
I'm first vice president of the chapter of South Carolina State University. We actually got in the community, post flyers, gave flyers out to random go-byers that was in the community, encouraging them to vote hard. Pretty much, we are not for one candidate. We are just specifically pushing the fact that voting is real, real, really critical this year, and you have to do it. It's pretty much cool to vote. It's nothing bad about it.
I didn't go to sleep until 2. We got up at 3, and we had to be at the bus at 4:30. So I've been excited ever since 2 o'clock this morning. This is my first time getting up this early for NAACP, but I'm excited, and I'm excited to vote. Actually, I voted already. I did an absentee ballot. The time is now.
What makes me excited is that not just the college chapters, but the high school level, who can't vote this election, but will vote next election, who are here to excite and get other people to vote. So that's exciting to me. What also is exciting to me is all the college chapters that are here, all the young people that kept the excitement going throughout the day, throughout the curves, buses broke down, people said racist comments, but continuously we are on point, and that's what is motivating the Youth of College Division, South Carolina, and everybody else here today.
I'm with the Allen University Chapter in Columbia, South Carolina.
The Youth of College Division has been freedom fighters since 1936, and will continue to be freedom fighters.
We're just getting out and empowering everyone to go out and vote. This is an important election. This is a big election. We just want to make sure that everyone in the communities knows where to go and vote, how to go and vote, and that's basically what we're doing. It's so beautiful to see so many young people coming together and going out into the communities just to get people to vote. It's beautiful.
And not only that, we encourage them to join the NAACP also.
It has been an extraordinary day, leaving Orangeburg at 5 a.m. in the morning, going to Rock Hill, Clover, South Carolina, and then journeying on to Allen University with 5 or 6 buses and motorcades, just really traveling and exciting people to get out the vote. And those persons, we encourage those 65-year-olds and older to go ahead and vote now. This election is so important. I know every election is important, but this one is extremely important.
I feel a huge amount of energy in this room with young folks. They're optimistic, and I'm especially proud of the Goose Creek branch of the NAACP, whose t-shirts are being worn by every one of these vote hard, think hard bus riders. Welcome to Goose Creek. Vote hard, think hard. If you vote hard and think hard, I know our country will be in good hands.
Vote hard.
Nourishment for the young people, for the soul, the mind, and the body. Especially it's because it's time to vote.
We started up in New York and worked our way city by city, in a sense, down towards Columbia, where we stopped for a noonday rally at Allen University. We then left Allen University, heading here, stopping at stopping in Sumter, Somerton, and Manning, hitting about 7 to 8 locations in all those different places. And now we have wrapped up our night on Main Street, and it has just been inspiring and empowering.
Good evening. Good evening. Fired up.
Fired up.
Ready to go.
Ready to go.
Somewhere.
Somewhere.
Somehow.
Somehow.
but you must know that your work will not be forgotten. This is an historical election. But as my president stated in many of his speeches before, this is not the most important election of your life. Every election is the most important election in your life. I was asked by a couple of news, a couple of media this afternoon and earlier this morning through Stephanie Brown in her office, they asked me, what is exciting you on today? And my comment to them was that what's exciting me on today was that I'm not knocking the college chapters at all. I'm excited that the college chapters are here. But to see high school students who cannot vote, that were participating in getting people to vote, is exciting. Yeah. That is exciting. That is exciting. We all stand on the shoulders of Malcolm X, Martin Luther King Jr., W.E.B. Du Bois, our grandparents, our great-grandparents, and of course, our parents. For they all came before us to do the same thing that we did on today. As Dr. Lonnie Randall stated, we, as he looked at that green bus pulling to Allen University today, he said, Lord, does that remind me of the Freedom Ride? And today we fought for freedom. What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
When do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
I am so glad you all continue to join South Carolina University.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Michael Heitzler. I'm the mayor for the city of Goose Creek, and I'm here this evening on behalf of the people of the city of Goose Creek to welcome all of you. I'm also here on behalf of our county supervisor, Dan Davis, to welcome you to Berkeley County. This is the last stop of a long bus ride that I think all of you can be proud of. There's a huge amount of energy. I felt the energy as soon as I got out of my car and parked it and came into the dining hall. I noticed that we had high school students. I chatted with some. I've chatted with college students. We have people working on master's degrees in this group.
Woo!
People working on doctorate degrees in this group. We have energy. We have intelligence. We have people that are committed. And I want to just, at this time, on behalf of Goose Creek City Council and the people of the city of Goose Creek, I just recognize President Andre Glover, who's the president of the Goose Creek NAACP, and tell her how proud we are of that excellent, excellent organization in the Goose Creek community.
As I stated as we started this morning in York, that South Carolina was our test state. Next week, we have Alabama, Georgia, and Mississippi. And they all have been ringing my phones, what's going on, what's happening? I said, we are fired up. So South Carolina has put together a great model for the rest of the states to follow. We do have pictures. They have uploaded your comments, your information to the NAACP's website as we started in York. So when you get a chance and you get home and they're able to get on the internet and go to www.naacp.org, you can see the comments that many of you have made through our communications department and also information that they were able to capture from the web.
Young people, friends, it is great to see you all here this evening. Are you fired up?
Fired up!
Are you fired up?
Fired up!
Ready to vote?
Ready to vote!
Tuesday?
Tuesday!
Tuesday!
November 4th.
November 4th.
As Mady just said, she really said it all. You all are a great sight to see. And you're great to see because I think about you are the hopes and the dreams of our ancestors in the past. You are doing it, ladies and gentlemen, and you're doing it for you and generations to come. So I say congratulations on this wonderful kickoff. And as Mady just said, we know you're gonna close that gap by taking everybody you can with you to the polls on November 4th.
We thank you, God bless you. Safe travels as you go back home. And remember, we have to continue to push and encourage everyone to get out and vote. Thank you for coming to Goose Creek.